Good morning, students. Today's topic, Unit 1, Learning the Game. The lesson is about the famous cricketer Sachin Tendulkar. Each one of us have different goals. Consider me, my goal was to become a teacher. So I achieved. Maybe I must have faced different difficulties. I studied. I faced the difficulties and I achieved it. So all of a sudden, I cannot frame my goal. I have to pass on different difficult situation to reach my goal. So students, it's your age now. It's your time to maintain a goal and work towards the goal. Clear? Okay. Your goal may be by 2022 to score 70% mark in higher secondary board exam, and another 4 years you will complete any degree, and then the next following 4 years you will finish your higher degrees. Then after that you will be searching for a job, then you will be taking that job and trying to do the best in that. So that's what your career. So up to that, you have to face different challenges. Challenge the situation. Only then you can achieve your goal. Students, aim high. Your goal must be a bigger goal. Higher goal, aiming high. So dream bigger. So set a goal and take immediate action. So plan all your goals. Only then your action may be set right to achieve your goal. In this lesson, we'll see how Sachin Tendulkar has made his goal, how he faced the difficulties, and how he succeeded to reach the goal. And Sachin Tendulkar was born on 24th April 1973 in Mumbai. He is a very good batsman and he is also called the Little Master, Master Blaster, are the different nicknames for him. Now we shall learn the different hard words of this lesson. The first one, emulate. So look at the picture given there. There's a son and a father. The son is imitating, doing the same for the father what he's doing. So this is called emulate. Emulate meaning imitate. Doing the same as others doing. The small boy is doing the same what the father is doing. The son is imitating the dad. That's a new word for this one, imitate, emulate. The next new word is overawed, meaning impressed so much. Now look at the picture. There are four ladies. Three are at one side listening to another lady presentation. The presenter's presentation is impressed so much by the other three ladies. That's why they laugh. They are wondered by the views of the presenter. This attitude, impressing so much, is called overawed. Overawed meaning impressed so much. The next new word is induction, meaning including someone to an organization. Look at the picture. See, ICC Hall of Fame. In the ICC Hall of Fame, Sachin was included by their another legend, Alan Donald, a South African player. So this is a prestigious issue. So Sachin was included in an organization. organization ICC Hall of Fame, along with another legend, Alan Donald. So for including someone to an organization, you can give a new word in English, induction, including someone to an organization. Is it clear? Induction, what's the meaning? Including someone to an organization. The next new word is insist, meaning demand strongly. Look at the picture. There are two girls. One girl with a helmet, she is working something. Another girl, she is giving a piece of paper where she is asking the other one to do something. So what's the reply from the girl with the helmet? I don't want them anymore. So that's what the reply. But even after that reply, the other girl, she's asking continuously to do the same. She's very firm in asking the same thing to the girl who is working. She's demanding strongly, continuously. She's asking very strongly about a message to the other girl, is what insist. So insist meaning demand strongly. Demand strongly. Insist. Demand strongly. The next new word is rigorous, meaning extremely thorough effort. I have shown you two pictures here. The first picture, some soldiers struggling hard to walk through a channel of water where wire gauze is along the channel. So wiry lines, electric lines are there. So underneath the wiry lines, they have to pass through. See, this is actually a training for the soldiers. See, only then they can get an effort. This training may support them, firm in within them. So that's what the first picture. Look at the second picture. I think most of the girls, you might be known this girl, this lady. She is Sudha Chandran. She's an Indian Bharatanatyam dancer. Actually, she is an artist, acted in many films, also teleserial performer. Okay. But what is the history behind this is she's held up with an accident and lost her leg. With one leg, she continues with a continuous practice. She became a Bharatanatyam dancer and she has got a credit to award because of this. So basically, Bharatanatyam dancer, after the accident, she was able to come up with a thorough effort. So this is called rigorous. So extremely thorough effort is called rigorous. So students, you can also have extremely thorough effort to achieve your goal. Is it clear? So rigorous meaning extremely thorough effort. Next new word, exhausted. Look at the picture. A girl with all this work bending, she is fast asleep. Maybe she may be tired. So she is lying down, forgetting all her works. So all her laptop, notebooks, everything is opened, not yet shut down, but she is sleeping. That means he shows she is very tired. So tired, another new word for this one is exhausted. Exhausted, tired. The next new word is nonce. I have given you two pictures here. First, it is familiar for you, different smileys, maybe laughter, anger, smile, cry, all those things. Second one, the prize stand, 1, 2, 3. So this means the first prize holder, the first winner should stand the center, second to one side and third to one side. So looking at the stages and on the stage of the prize winner stage, you may be able to find who gets the first, who gets the second, who comes third. So This is not explained. Without explanation by the symbol or the signs, you are able to get the expression. This is called nonce. So nonce meaning different expression. The next new word is pursue, follow or chase. The picture, there's a student walking along the staircase. So he'll be climbing along the staircase until he reaches the cup. So that's what his aim. The student's aim is to reach the cup and own the best student cup. Like you all say, so you will become an engineer. So you have to follow all the, follow the hurdles, follow the happiness. You have to you face all your, all type of situation until you reach your goal. It's what pursue. So pursue, follow or chase. Next is vadapav. It's a dish native of Maharashtra. It's actually a deep fried potato dumpling inside a bread bun. So vadapav is a dish, fast food dish in Maharashtra. Next new word is immense, meaning massive or enormous. Simply saying big. Immense, massive, enormous, vast. Now look at the pictures here. Two weightlifters pictures are here. Karnam Malleshwari, Mirabai Chanu. Mirabai Chanu takes the place of Karnam Malleshwari. Karnam Malleshwari is the first women weightlifter of Kerala, from Kerala. Yes? Okay, now after her retirement, Mirabai takes the place. So now here, how do you relate these two pictures in the word immense? See, they have taken a very good effort, a big effort. Only then, only after that only, they were able to hold the place, the first women weightlifter. The first women weightlifter. So they have gained a title. And even we are learning them in India in our newspapers about them. So this can be done only by their big effort. Everyday skill. Every day they are training themselves to improve their skill. Only then they are able to take this place. So this is what immense, massive, enormous. The next is stamina. Meaning the ability to sustain prolonged physical or mental effort. Look at the picture. Some girls are playing on a ground. See, so that's why I given their outdoor game, not inside the within the four walls, not within the four walls. When you play outside, maybe like players train themselves on a ground, they are able to get their physical and mental effort. So a situation where you get the physical and mental effort is called stamina. So outdoor games provide you stamina, whereas indoor game, they never give you a physical effort, maybe mental effort. Correct? So outdoor games gives you stamina. Stamina meaning ability to sustain prolonged physical or mental efforts. The next word, cocktail. It's a mixed alcoholic fruit drink. Mixed alcoholic fruit drink with all the fruit juices mixed. So it's a cocktail. Cocktail, mixed alcoholic fruit drink. The next word is kit bag. It's a bag, it's an ordinary bag to carry all your accessories. Cricket kit bag is a bag where you carry all cricket accessories. So kit bag, bag to carry cricket accessories. The next new word, inevitable, that is impossible to avoid. Look at the picture, a small kid is left alone in a room. So the natural sense is fear. Elder ones, we won't be afraid when you are left alone, correct? Maybe you'll be sometimes afraid when you see a different animal. be a barking dark like that. But in the pictures, she is very small. So looking at the dark, she is afraid. So fear in sense is a feeling that cannot be avoided. So such a feeling is called inevitable. A feel that cannot be avoided. It's impossible to avoid. The next new word, stride, stage in progress towards an aim. The picture you can see three athletes running. Within a few minutes, they may reach the final line, the end line. So during the last peak timing, the effort given by them, by the players. So how will the effort be? The effort will be very strong. I think you must have seen players 5 or 8 rounds. First round, they'll be running very slowly. But towards the last round, they take the effort. They fasten the running time. And slowly they increases the speed and finally reaches the end line. So the last, see, even you children, to the exam time, how you put on your effort. The beginning, how will be your effort? Compare these two. So during the exam time, the effort given by you is the stride. Is it clear? So what is stride? Stage in progress towards an aim. Next new word, embarrass, meaning feel ashamed. The picture, a girl is being scolded by too many people, some 5 people. So what is her feeling? Ashamed. So this situation is called embarrass. The next new word, melee, meaning a confused crowd of people. Look at the picture. Few boys are playing on the road. It's a very confusing situation. Why these boys are playing here? So everybody will question them. So these boys are a questioned people, confused people, a confused crowd. So this is called melee. Making a confused situation. Playing cricket on the road will create a confusion to the bypasses. So this is called melee, a confused crowd of people. The next new word, insane, meaning fun games. There are certain games only kids can only play. Even you can see there are several water theme park, fun game, fun zone, where some games are only for kids. Even the picture you can see some kids playing a fun game. So such games are called insane, fun games. Next new word, transpare, meaning revealed. There are 2 pictures here. First one, a small boy. Second one, a famous cricket player. Most of us know who he is. He is the present cricket captain, Virat Kohli. The first picture is his childhood. So both the pictures are here. Virat Kohli's childhood picture and the present pictures. So small boy has revealed as a great cricket player now. The next new word, orientation, meaning the course which must be taken in order to reach a destination. So that is, there are different courses. So there are different options. It's left to you to reach a destination. So options be taken by the person so that it would help him to reach his destination. This is what orientation. Many choices, many options will be there. But the candidate or the person should choose where to go. So he may appear for different classes to which course he can take. He can ask different personalities to help him to choose the option. So what is orientation? The different options to be taken in order to reach a destination. The next new word, personality. It is one's character or feature or interest. So there's a picture here. It is Parimarjan Nehi. He is now 27 years old. But at the age of his 13 years, he was titled as Grandmaster in chess. 13-year-old Grandmaster. So who is the 13-year-old Grandmaster? Parimarjan Nehi. So personality doesn't mean the beauty, the external beauty, but it is one's character, feature or interest. So what is the personality of Parimarjan Nehi? He is a Grandmaster, a chess player. So personality meaning one's character, one's feature or one's interests. The next word is dragged off, to force someone to tell you something when they do not want to, like insist. So dragged off, you can say insist also. So the picture, there's a mother and a kid. The boy has asked something, but the mother refused to do it and she is pulling him towards her way. So the boy is asking something what the mother doesn't want to do. So this situation is called dragged off, to force someone to tell you something what they do not want to. So dragged off, to force someone to tell you something when they do not want to. The next new word, sheepish, meaning foolish. Look at the picture. The man is fooled by somebody. When he reveals that he is fooled, he gives a smile. So that moment is called, that moment feeling is called sheepish. Sheepish, foolish. The next new word, farsightedness, meaning prudent awareness of future. The picture, the mother taking care of two children, but she is seen to be by the side of a son. It doesn't mean that she never cares a daughter. She knew already that the son needs more support than the daughter. Maybe the daughter is cleverer than the son. So looking at far away, she just see the whether the daughter is learning or not. So she could study both the children, the nature of both the children, looking as to being far away. So this is called farsightedness. Taking care by looking after them, being far. It's a prudent awareness of future. Next new word, bunked, to make oneself absent from a class. Here in the picture, some boys, they are attracted by a small paper boat floating on a stream of water. So they stop there on the way to school. They just getting absent from a class and started to play with the paper boat. That means they bunked, to make oneself absent from a class. Bunked meaning to make oneself absent from a class. Next new word, anticipation, meaning forthcoming emotional process. Anticipation, forthcoming emotional process. Most of us know the young girl who she is. She's Greta Thunberg, an environmentalist. So, though very young, though a school child, she never recollect the future events that she might face. Without bothering about that, she in a organization, she communicate with the high people, higher officials, and she progressed her views in front of them. So she did not bother about the emotional process in that would be faced by her in future. So this is called anticipation, forthcoming emotional process. Greta Thunberg, without bothering about the forthcoming emotional process, she presented all her views in a meeting where higher officials were gathered there. So anticipation, forthcoming emotional process. Disciplinarian, meaning a person who practices firm discipline. So disciplinarian, a person who practices firm discipline. So everybody should lead a disciplined life. The people who follows a disciplined life is termed disciplinarian. So there's a picture of a school headmistress who follows certain rules, regulations very strictly. That is actually the picture is taken from a cinema character, though there are true characters like this. Understand? So such a person who follows strict discipline in the life are called disciplinarian. Even there is a quote of Theodore Roosevelt, with self-discipline, most anything is possible. So every student in your young age itself, you should follow, you should have a disciplined life. Even so, you can also be a disciplinarian, correct? The game is an extract from Sachin Tendulkar's biography, Playing It My Way. Sachin is one of the greatest cricketers and batsmen of all time. From a very early age, he played cricket. He tried to emulate the famous cricketers Sunil Gavaskar and Viv Richards. Brother Ajit and his coach has influenced a lot in molding Sachin's talents. Sachin was 11 years old. Ajit introduced him to the coach Ramkant Agrikar. The coach had entered the cricket field at the age of 13. Sachin also entered the cricket field at the age of 13. This was their common link. This was the common link between the student and the coach. Sachin had never batted in the nets before, so he was overawed. Therefore, on his first trial, he got nervous and so he did not perform well. Knowing the capability of Sachin, Ajit pleaded for another opportunity. He asked the coach to watch Sachin from far. Finally, he agreed to join the camp. How did Sachin's father, that is Ramesh Tendulkar, supported Sachin to boost his talent? Sachin's father allowed Sachin to change school because in the beginning where he studied, no cricket training was given. So he allowed Sachin to change the school. He advised him to change schools only if he was really serious about playing cricket. And he came to talking home after the practice session at Shivaji Park. So every practice session he used to come there and take him home. He encouraged his son, saying all he wanted him to do and trying his best without worrying about the result. And how did Sachin's brother, that is Ajit Tendulkar, helped him, supported him, identified Sachin's talent in cricket? He took Sachin to the camp to get trained at the Agrikar Sir's. He insisted on Sir giving Sachin another chance. He accompanied him to the camp for some days. Also, how did Sachin's coach supported Sachin Tendulkar? Sachin's coach agreed to train Sachin in cricket. He trained Sachin during the summer camp. He used to call Sachin's father and suggested changing Sachin's school. He trained Sachin at his new school, Sharada Ashram Vidya Mandir. School, Sachin's school, Lee English school, where no cricket facilities were provided. Sachin was shifted to Sharada Ashram Vidya Mandir as Ramkant Agrikar was the coach there. What made Sachin possible to achieve his goal? His rigorous practice, 7:30 a.m. to 10:30 p.m. And finally, the evening ends with exhausted state. and he has only one set of clothes. Every day he has to wash the clothes. So repeated washing of a set of cricket clothes. And his brother Ajit used to explain the different tricks of batting. So he used to give discussion about cricket with his brother Sachin. So all this made Sachin a great cricketer. So it has to be said, father, brother and coach, and Sachin's own effort and other supporters, the other three supporters, made him to achieve his goal. Very rarely Sachin used to bunk the practice. So that time what happens is, when Sachin bunked practice and played innocent games with the colony boys, his coach would come to the melee and spot him out in the scooter. During the daily practice and towards the last 15 minutes, Agarkar would place a 1 rupee coin on top of the stumps. And if Sachin managed to avoid getting out, the coin was his own. That is, Sachin would own the coin. In this session, every bowler in the camp would come and bowl to him with some 60 to 70 boys fielding. It meant that he had to hit every ball along the ground to survive those intense 15 minutes. So the last 15 minutes will be a heavy practice by the coach, given by the coach. The coach used to advise him, practice hard and see what magic can transpire. In Sachin's autobiography, Learning the Game, he has stated two treats, particularly Sachin's dad treat and Sachin's coach treat. Sachin's coach, Ramkant Agarkar, used to give money to buy vada pav, which gave immense satisfaction when completely drained. So during a 30 minutes break, Agarkar would often give Sachin some money to go and have a vada pav, a popular Mumbai fast food. Unreasonable demand to his father for cocktail also supported him to realize his parents' love. So he has mentioned the two treats. The money what Sachin's father has paid to buy a cocktail, and the sir who has given money to Sachin to buy a vada pav, a popular Mumbai fast food. Now a very brief about Sachin's goal setting. Brother Ajit's nonce of batting and dad's support, hard practice and his training, managing to avoid getting out to own the 1 rupee of the coach placed on the stump helps him to improve concentration. Runs two circuits of Shivaji Park build up physical and mental stamina. His repeated rigorous practice and utilizing the opportunities to do better. Difficulties he faced in the bus journey taught him learning experiences. So Sachin faced very different situation to achieve the sportsman quality, that is determination, optimization, stamina, perseverance, decisiveness. So this all these made Sachin to achieve his goal. Now it's time to write a summary of this lesson in your own words. I have also given a summary here. You can make use of this too. Writing summary in your own words will help your writing skill. Agarkar looked after all players really well. During the training session, he worked sincerely and gave rigorous training to everyone in the camp. Had it not happened for Agarkar, Sachin would not be the cricketer. The coach Agrikar was a strict disciplinarian and did everything. Therefore, he could give the legendary Sachin Tendulkar. Sachin Tendulkar, in his biography, stated about Guru Purnima, as we say, Teacher's Day. While stating about his guru, he says, "Guru is one's better version launcher. One's better version launcher." So Sachin has stated about Guru Purnima, the Teacher's Day. He states that it's the day we remember those who have taught us to be better version of ourselves. That is, a student has changed his version to the best version. He has transformed to a better version. That will be done only by his teacher. So Agrikar was stated by Sachin as his better version launcher. So he thus gave him a great salute to his guru, Ramkant Agrikar. In the picture, you can find Sachin with another two friends meeting with his guru, Ramkant Agrikar. So this shows how grateful the players were with his guru. So what does the biography reveal as? Everybody should be grateful to your teachers. Teacher is not a mentor or the people who you see at the school. Your parent may be your teacher. Your teachers who teaches you different subjects are your teachers. Or the different old people who are around you are your teachers. So you should be grateful to your teachers who give you, who shares your experience, which helps you to come up in your life. And today's assignment, Sachin's rigorous practice and hard work made him a living cricket. What should one do to achieve his goal? Second question, Agrikar was a sincere coach. Substantiate. Have a nice day. Thank you for listening.